The James Webb Space Telescope has successfully inserted itself into its orbit, at the Earth-Sun Lagrange Point 2, doing so at 2:05 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on January 24, 2022. The insertion into L2 orbit signifies the end of the observatory's immensely complex deployment process, and the beginning of the telescope's commissioning activities. The orbit insertion maneuver began at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, lasted for 5 minutes, and added 1.6 meters per second velocity to Webb to send it into its proper orbit. James Webb teams and engineers have confirmed that the burn to insert the observatory into a halo orbit around Lagrange Point 2 appears to have been completely nominal. Additionally, teams completed numerous other tasks throughout the week leading to orbit insertion. "We got all of our mirrors out of their launch configuration this week," added Parrish. "The spacecraft team has continued to put the spacecraft through all of its paces, and the flight operations team, mission operations team, and all of our engineer teams have really become comfortable with operating Webb, and continuing to get to know it. Also in the past few days, we've gotten our high-speed data system up and running. We can now transmit at the high data rates. We need to get all that awesome science data back down to the ground, when we start doing science. The last 30 days have been absolutely remarkable, and we've got it behind us, and it's an incredible accomplishment by the entire team," Parrish said. However, engineers still need to analyze the raw data collected by Webb during the burn to confirm precise details of the maneuver, as this burn was the first to use the observatory's station-keeping thruster that will also help keep it in a stable orbit while at L2. But the real question is, can this JWST achieve it? Is it possible that James Webb will be able to see? How did this universe begin? Were we alone in this huge cosmos before the Big Bang? Just some of the numerous questions that scientists have been pondering for years. Like this one. They planned a slew of projects and missions to gather as much information as possible about our origins in the universe we live in, but no technology existed to do it. The James Webb Space Telescope, a large telescope, was then built by scientists and is expected to help us understand the origins of the cosmos. Thousands of light years into the future, we'll be discussing this. In today's video, a new era of astronomy is just around the corner, provided everything goes according to plan. After a nail-biting launch on Christmas Day, the James Webb Space Telescope JWST has launched its mission to capture the birth of the universe. James Webb Space Observatory will be NASA's largest and most powerful space research telescope, exploring the cosmos to learn more about the universe's history from its Big Bang to the birth of alien planet. And beyond, the observatory will cost $10 billion. It is part of NASA Great Observatories, which comprise the Hubble Space Telescope and other massive space telescopes that can stare into the universe. What if JWST's primary goals is exploration of galaxy formation, more than 13.5 billion years before the Big Bang, a hitherto unobserved period of cosmic history that formed our universe as we know it today? According to NASA, JWST was built to observe a time in the universe's history that has not yet been observed before. Rather than to study the origins of the cosmos, we prefer to think if the JWST is a successor to the Hubble Space Telescope, rather than a replacement more than 30 years after its launch. The Hubble Space Telescope has provided us with a breathtaking views of the universe and countless scientific discoveries. It is our hope and expectation that it will continue for many more years to come. However, the Hubble Telescope, S2.4-meter diameter mirror, compared to a ground-based telescope's lenses, sensitivity and ability to observe the faintest objects. This is a limitation. Even though Hubble can observe infrared light, it cannot access the light wavelengths from the very first stars and galaxies. Hubble has some capability to observe infrared light. JWST, on the other hand, will be able to do this task for the very first time. We may even be able to observe stars that were generated from primordial material from the Big Bang. Knowing when and how the first stars originated soon after the Big Bang is an important scientific subject and one of the key science teams of JWST. Carbon, silicon and gold, which are essential to life and contemporary technology, were produced in the early stars. But how they did so is still a mystery. Once, as a result, the design of this observatory has been influenced greatly by the fact that it needs to be extremely cool to reduce the amount of unwanted background light. It's not just the initial stars and galaxies. that will be studied by JWST researchers from all over the world can apply for time at this observatory, which is designed to serve a variety of purposes. Infrared observation will allow JWST to see through the clouds of dust that enshroud very young stars which are impenetrable to the visible light of the telescope. That means it will be able to see directly into star-forming regions, something Hubble hasn't been able to do yet. The findings will shed light on the formation of stars, and the systems of planets that orbit them. As a result of the collapse of dust and gas clamps, Webb will be able to see further into the universe than Hubble, and it will be far more sensitive. This will allow Webb to go back much farther in time and view the earliest galaxies that formed in the early universe. According to NASA, this telescope is so powerful that even if you were a bumblebee, 240,000 miles away, the distance between Earth and the Moon we could see that, what NASA Goddard Space Flight Center senior project scientist John Mathis at What in the World is going on here. Science instruments on board the JWST will be able to observe in the visible, near-infrared, and mid-infrared wavelengths respectively. The wavelengths of infrared light are longer than those of visible light, but they are shorter than those of radio waves, NASA Goddard Space Flight Center. Paul Geithner argues that there are numerous reasons to study in the infrared, and that the James Webb Space Telescope is no exception. As the universe has grown older, the ultraviolet and visible light emitted in its early days has been stretched and is now reaching us as infrared light over 13 billion years after it was first released. As soon as the first rays of light begin to appear, Webb will be ready more than two decades ago, when the first ideas of JWST were being debated. Only the planets in our own solar system were known. Scientists have now found thousands of planets orbiting different stars in the Milky Way throughout this period. It is expected that a considerable portion of the JWST monitoring schedule will be devoted to studying their atmospheres. In comparison to Earth-based observatories, JWST wavelength coverage is particularly well suited to researching chemicals in extraterrestrial atmospheres and the lower infrared background from space. There are two ways to go about this. One can take advantage of a dip in the star's light caused by planets passing in front of it, a transit before and during transit we can discover the composition of the planet atmosphere by analyzing the light split down by wavelength with remarkable precision. Coronagraphs can be used to obscure the light from the parent star. Another possibility is that the stars and planets are born in obscuring gas and dust clouds. Because infrared light can pass through clouds, we can see what's going on up there. Until now, we don't know how the universe developed from a simpler state of hydrogen and helium. Did the universe we observe today, but the Webb telescope will help us answer these critical issues. The first galaxies will be discovered using near-infrared surveys, followed by low-resolution spectroscopy and photometry in the mid-infrared. Researchers will need to use high-resolution near-infrared spectroscopy to observe things that have never been seen before. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.